Hello, my name's Vanda. So, I want to share the story of how I got my first rosary. And since it is the month of May, which is this has inspired me to share some of my experiences with Mary, and it has an impact on my conversion story. I'm a convert to Catholicism. Last year, 2017, the 100th anniversary of Fatima. Okay, that's another story to come. So, I'm going to share how I got this rosary. It's my first rosary, and it's really special to me because of the story that it holds. Anyways, so I want you to understand, I have a religious vocation. There's a Marian aspect to this too. Before, I mean, I was literally only a Christian, like a true Christian. Not just, okay, I believe in Jesus and God, but I'm not gonna pray or go to church properly. Or I go to church, but I'm like, whatever with prayer, you know? No, I mean, like a real Christian going to church and actually praying daily. I mean, really praying. So I was only a real Christian, as I say, for 3 months. And I will relay that story another time. But Mary had an influence in that. I figure this one. How I got my rosary for the first time is an important one because I feel like there are not enough Catholics praying the rosary. And I think maybe if I share this story, it might inspire them. I will start by saying how I found this store called Ave Maria. Now, I live in Germany. I'm gonna put the rosary down because I'm fiddling with it. I live in Germany and Catholicism is present, but it's hard to find Christian shops, okay? Especially me, I live in the middle of nowhere. This shop is in the middle of the city. This shop was in Berlin, close to Viriati Wintergarten. So if you're German, you might know where that is. It's close to that area. It's still there. It recently just moved a little bit further down. But it's still there, and at that time, that the sign that they had was basically tiny, obscure, made of wood, falling apart. It was hard to recognize. But we drove past it, and I went, "Oh my gosh, Ave Maria!" Because I was kind of going through this discernment process of religious vocation, going, "Oh my gosh, I would have to become Catholic. What's happening?" And so there was like this Catholic sign, Ave Maria. You know, right there. Shop was built in 1996. That's the year I was born in. So that made it even more special. And the shopkeeper there, her name is Raquel, her birthday is the day after my birthday. These little details just made that space more home. You know, these little details. Sometimes God, like, he puts little details to kind of draw you in. So, anyways, sorry, the light is kind of going nuts. Because I've seen this a couple times driving by, you know, we rarely go down that street, but whenever I saw it, I'd see it. I'm going, oh my gosh, I want to go inside. I really want to go inside. So one time I had the courage to just say, hey mom, guess what? There's this Ave Maria shop there. Maybe we could just go in and get some Jesus things, you know, some Christian stuff. And my mom was going, isn't that like a Catholic store or something? But, you know, my mom's not a bigot, so she still goes in with me one day and I'm already nervous as is. I'm about to enter Catholicism. Okay, something I've been thinking about intently for a long time, but specifically religious vocation and, you know, nuns and stuff like that, you know, habits. I'm going in hoping to get some understanding because I didn't have any Catholic friends. More real Christian-like friends I had were Protestant, so I couldn't really share this with them. So I'm walking in, I'm at the door. Super nervous, my heart's pounding. I open the door, and there in front of me is this giant Jesus statue pointing into his sacred heart. I'm going, oh my gosh, there's Jesus. And then seconds later, there's a giant Mary statue right behind him, pointing to her Immaculate Heart. I'm just basically frozen, you know? I'm going, oh my gosh, Mary, Jesus. And then I look around, and there are just saints everywhere, and there's Mary everywhere, and there's Jesus everywhere, and they're just crucifixes, you know. I mean, I had this huge thirst for crucifixes because in Protestantism, you don't really really see crucifixes that much, so I felt like wanting a crucifix was somehow wrong or would be shunned, because I wanted Jesus. I didn't just want a stick, you know, shaped like this. I wanted Jesus, you know. I just wanted him and to see him and to really understand what, you know, he did for us. I wanted to understand personally. That's another time. So I would go in completely overwhelmed and really feeling aware of how sinful I am. I'm going, I'm not worthy to be in here. I feel, you know, like a fish out of water. And yeah. But the Lord is good and generous, and Akela, she just opened, you know, her heart to us. They're saintly people. I met her, spoke with her, and I went, oh my gosh, I'm speaking to a saint. She is just so holy, so childlike, and filled with so much Christ-like love. And when we left, she gave us a miraculous medal. So we took this medal. I went like, oh my gosh, it's something Catholic, and I own it. Yay, you know? And I immediately put it around my necklace and wore it every single day. And it was already blessed, because this is an Italian woman. She's going to make sure that her things in the store are blessed. And if it's not blessed yet, she's going to make sure it is. She'll take it to her priest, have it blessed, and then you'll have to pick it up, because it has to be blessed first. So this is how Catholic she is, and devout and loving. Obviously a Catholic store, what would they sell other than statues of saints, crucifixes, portraits of Jesus? What would they sell? Well, that would be rosaries. So I saw this long row of beautiful rosaries, and I'm basically internally longing to touch them. I just want to touch them, and I want to look at them, and I want to have one. Why? I still was conflicted about Mary. I was still, you know, skeepish. German, English, Danish in my brain. Skeptic about the rosary. But I was open-minded. So I'm going now to the Catholics to understand, what do they mean with Mary and rosaries? So I saw aspects of truth, you know, in these things. So I kept on hearing, you know, it's a powerful tool for prayer. Going, I want to know how it is to pray this. Why is it powerful? I want to try. I want to try and see what the fruit is. I'm not going to just assume that it's false because that's what they say, instead of listening what, you know, the ones who actually pray it say. Here's my thirst for the rosary. That's why, because I heard it was a powerful tool of prayer, and I wanted to, I guess, experience, is this true? Is this true? But just glancing at the rosaries was painful for me. I mean, it was scary. I did not have the guts to tell my mom, hey, I'd like a rosary, because I wasn't at that level yet. One day, on a Saturday, sometime before Christmas, and this thought in my head, or it kind of said in a very, you know, very loud, oh, I really love a rosary. I just want one. But I don't have any money. That was out of the question. I knew it was never going to happen. I can never get a rosary.
So then, God, the next day, I guess he figured, huh, well, let's help this poor, scared child get what she needs and wants, since she cannot do that on her own. The next day, my mother's friend, and she's also a lapsed Catholic, she's left the faith, so we need to pray for her. So she comes to me, and she gives me this little plastic pouch with beads inside, and this picture of some dude with like some kind of cone. And, you know, that, through the eyes of a Protestant who knows very little about the church. And she says, here, it's blessed by the Pope. And I'm going, yeah, okay, the Pope. Okay, me, Protestant, especially Protestant who's only been Christian for, like, truly spiritually Christian, living like a Christian for a couple months, hearing Pope, I'm just thinking, old man, white clothes, weird hat, and only one dude of that kind. So that's my concept of Pope. But in turn, I'm going, oh my gosh, what am I getting here? And so I run upstairs, lock my door, and open up this little plastic pouch to figure out what is inside this thing. And so that's when I got this. This is what was inside. And at first, I didn't even recognize it. Okay, that's how little I know rosaries. I held it, I'm going, that's a weird necklace. And I tried putting it over my head. It doesn't fit. Why doesn't it fit? I went, where's the clasp? My little slow brain finally realized what I was holding in my hand. And it was a rosary. And I kind of freaked out. I'm now holding a rosary, something I really wanted for so long, okay? And I'm going, God, how did you know? And then I remembered, well, first of all, God, need I say more? But then I remembered, you know, the other day, I said, I want a rosary. That's how I got this rosary, but that's not all, because it was blessed by the Pope, and I'm pretty sure some of you guys are going, which Pope? Tell me, human. Well, the Pope who blessed it is, well, you know, was Pope John Paul. And when I found out the name meant little to me, but I started knowing him and learning about him and really started liking this old man wearing the funny white hat on his head. And then I realized, wait a second, he wasn't just Pope, but he's now a saint. I mean, he's canonized, he's a saint. And that just blew me away that not only do I have a rosary blessed by a pope, but he's now a saint in heaven. So I feel like this is my little spiritual, you know, spiritual relic from Pope John Paul, who is my spiritual grandpa in heaven praying for me. But that's not it. That's not it. One of the most unique things about this rosary are the beads. And I'll try to see if you guys can see. See, these are brown cat eye beads. Now, to you that'll mean nothing. Brown cat eye beads, big whoop. But me as a kid, for Mother's Day or for my mother's birthday, I would get her cat's eye stones. Specifically brown ones because she liked them more, you know. And this rosary is brown with cat's eye. And when that hit me, I'm going, wow. I mean, I totally forgot that I gave that to my mom as a kid. Later on, you know, in the spiritual process of discerning, becoming Catholic, and then, you know, religious vocation and stuff, I realized that Mary, through this, was not just giving me a rosary, but she's also conveying to me that she's my mother, too. These little beads helped me in a personal way, not just intellectually, but in a personal way, accept her as my mother, too. So I hope that this story of mine, of how I got this rosary, will inspire you guys to not just let your rosary collect dust, get up and pray it, because it's clearly important to God if he went through such lengths to just not just give me a rosary, but one so special. I mean, when the Mother of God, the Queen of Heaven, gives her children a gift, clearly she gives a gift. And so for me, whenever I look at this as the rosary the Blessed Virgin gave me, she gave this to me because she knew I needed it. So I hope this inspires you to pray the rosary. Try and praying it, and at some point praying it every day, because at Fatima, Mary specifically said to pray the rosary every day. Every day. Not once a week, every day. And if you can't afford one, or you're too scared, like me, too scared to get one, or you don't know where to look, well then, you know, Providence. There's this thing called Providence, which we Christians believe in. Providence. Pray and ask, and you shall receive. Have faith. God bless. Oh, and I forgot to show you the picture. It's a little bit wrinkled now, but here you go. See?
Pope John Paul, we love you. Pray for us.
Bye.